In this scripting session, we will show you how to create a custom script. Now I'll start working on the next section of the track. Here, I'm going to go through and pick out specific sounds in the music and apply lighting effects in time with those. I will delete the effects the automation has laid down so that I can add in something custom. Because I want to work on lights individually, I'll delete the information in the master track for now. I'll make a selection in the part of the song where there is a specific sound that I want to work with, and then I'll apply a pulse effect based on that sound. At the start of this part of the music, there is a sound where I want to alternate the flash of the lights. I'll choose a color, and then copy and paste that onto the other track. After listening to the track, I'll go through and add pulses in time with the sounds that I hear, and then change the color. Now before I play this back, I'll just stretch out the overrides so that my moving heads will stay turned off while the other lights flash. Then, I'll select all the parts that I've just created and copy and paste them over the next 8 bars. Now, I'll quickly add a position effect and then play it back and see how it looks. After the first 4 bars, there is a new effect applied to that first sound, so I want to go through and apply a strobe effect to fit in time with the stutter effect in the music. Head over to soundswitch.com to download the latest version of the software.